are covering Chapter 17, the charge. Part 1, we covered how to learn all the sections of Chapter 17 through a trick word. Part 2, we covered Section 211. Part 3, we covered 212 and 213. Today, we are going to cover Section 214 and 215. Let's quickly revise what we have already covered. The contents, which is under Section 211, it has 7 parts. Section 212, it is TPP, time, place and person. Section 213, we covered the manner in which the offence is committed. Today we're gonna cover the sense, words in charge taken in sense of law under which offence is punishable. Section 214, or as we normally say, Section 214, it says words in charge taken in sense of law under which the offence is punishable. We need to understand what it's trying to explain us. Let's cover the section first. In every charge, words used in describing an offence shall be deemed to have been used in the sense attached to them respectively by the law under which such offence is punishable. Now we need to understand that when a charge is prepared, it is very obvious that the offense is explained. Now, when the offense is described in the charge, now we need to understand this line very carefully. It says that it shall be deemed, means a presumption is made. We are presuming the things. What we are presuming? That the offense which is given under this is making a sense that it is as per the law under which it comes. Let me explain with an example. If we say there is an assault or abuse, so it is going to be taken in the sense of the law under which it comes, means either it is covering the assault which is done under Juvenile Act, or the assault or the abuse done under the SCST Act, or the assault and abuse, whatever the word may be used, which comes under the POSCO Acts. There are various other examples, but I'm just trying to limit over here to make it understandable that this is what Section 214 explains us. I hope you understand the concept of Section 214. After covering the sense, that is Section 214, let's cover the errors, which is Section 215, effects of errors. Section 215, effects of errors. Section 215 says no errors in stating either the offense or the particulars required to be stated in the charge. Now, the first part of the section says the error in either the offense or the particulars. Okay, next it says and no omission to state the offense or those particulars. Omission means anything which is left out or not included in, it's excluded. Shall be regarded at any stage of the case as material. Now, it will not be considered as relevant. Why it is not going to be considered as relevant? Let's cover the section. You will understand it. Unless the accused was in fact misled by such error or omission and it has occasioned a failure of justice, it will be considered only if the accused was misled by such error or omission and the court was not able to give justice. Only in this case it will be taken into material, otherwise it will not be considered as material. This is what Section 215 says. Before I move ahead, let me cover effects of errors. Is about error in stating the offense or the particulars or omission. So now there are two things, the error or omission, and the happening of two things. One, it misled the accused. Two, it occasioned the failure of justice. Then it is going to be considered as material. Now let's cover the illustrations, which is the most important part from judicial point of view. A is charged under Section 242 of Indian Penal Code with having been in possession of counterfeit coin. Next it says, having known at the time when he became possessed thereof that such coin was counterfeit. Now the word fraudulently being omitted in the charge. The illustration further says, unless it appears that A was in fact misled by this omission, the error shall not be regarded as material. Now let's understand what it's saying. It's saying that if A was charged under Section 242 for having possession of counterfeit coin and it was mentioned in the charge that he was knowing at the time of possession that such coin was counterfeit. Now this is a crime. Now, while preparing the charge, what happened? The word fraudulently was missed, omitted, or not written because of any reason. Then this cannot be taken as an advantage that it is misleading. I cannot prepare myself defense. No, you know that you have been charged for keeping a counterfeit coin, even after knowing that it is a counterfeit coin. So such error will not be regarded as material, will not be regarded as relevant. I hope you understood this point. B. Second illustration. A is charged with cheating B, and the manner in which he cheated B is not set out in the charge or is set out incorrectly, which means that while preparing the charge, either how he has cheated B was not mentioned in it, or if it was mentioned, it was mentioned incorrectly. The A may defend himself, calls witnesses and gives his own account of the transaction, but the court may infer from this that the omission to set out the manner of the cheating is not material. I hope you are understanding the point, whether missing out something or mentioning something incorrectly will not be considered material, will not be taken in as a defense for the opponent. In such cases, the charge will still be considered as relevant. The omission or the mistake which we have just covered. So, not mentioning the fact that how he cheated does not mean the charge will not be considered as proper, if it's not misleading the accused. C. Third illustration. A is charged with cheating B, and the manner in which he cheated B is not set out in the charge. Yes, it is very much similar to the previous illustration we covered, but there is a change over here. There are many transactions between A and B. Now, this is where the difference is. And A had no means of knowing to which of them the charge referred and offered no defense. Now, the difference is that when there is many transaction between A and B, how will he know that which one is considered as cheating? In this case, now this is the difference. The court may infer from such facts that the omission to set out the manner of the cheating was, in this case, a material error. Means the error over here of not mentioning the manner in which he cheated B is a material error, is considered relevant, and such charge will not be considered as proper. D. The fourth illustration. A is charged with the murder of Khudabaksh on the 21st January 1882. Now let's cover what the facts are. In fact, the murdered person's name was Haiderbaksh, and the date of the murder was 20th January 1882. Now the difference is, in charge, the name of the person's murder was Khudabaksh, and the date of murder was 21st January 1882. But in reality, what happened? The murdered person name was Haiderbaksh, and he was murdered on 20th January 1882. Means there is an error in charge. But what happened? A was never charged with any murder but one. Means he had no other charges and had heard the inquiry before the magistrate, which referred exclusively to the case of Haiderbaksh. Now A was attending the inquiry in the murder case of Haiderbaksh, which was the real fact, not as per the charge. So the court may infer from these facts that A was not misled and that the error in the charge was immaterial. So this error can be ignored because there is no confusion for the accused to prepare defense. E. Fifth illustration. A is charged with murdering Haiderbaksh on 20th January 1882 and Khudabaksh, who tried to arrest him for that murder, on 21st January 1882. This means that A was charged with the murdering of Haiderbaksh on 20th, and when Khudabaksh, who tried to arrest him the next day, that is on 21st January, he murdered him as well. So when charge was prepared, that he was charged for the murder of Haiderbaksh only, but he was tried for the murder of Khudabaksh. Now look at the confusion. The witnesses present in his defense were witnesses in case of Haiderbaksh. So the court may infer from this that the A was misled and that the error was material. So the charge has to be rectified such charge will be considered as not proper. Before I come back with another section, please respect all people, rich or poor, love all kids, yours or others.